Shalom, Rastafari, Salam Tanah, Tanah Yastalin. I am Alonzo, and greetings, welcome, also all those tuning in to these video messages. This is concerning President Obama, but first, we must make mention. Earlier this year, we put out a video. It's called Ali Speaks on Being President. Now, Ali is being interviewed in the 1970s, and it's somewhere in between 1970s, 1980s. And he's the interviewer makes mention that, you know, the polls say that behind Nixon, you're the second most likely man to be voted president in the United States. Would you like to be president, Mr. Muhammad Ali? Muhammad Ali goes on to answer, no. It's too dangerous. And the crowd ignorantly laughs, right, including the interviewer. And now Muhammad Ali goes on to explain, listen, it's like I've been in the bottom of the ships. I've been doing hard labor. I've been mistreated. I've been in the gutters. I've been, you know, in the under filthy circumstances. All of a sudden, the captain of the boat comes down and asks me to go up with him, not only to the deck, but, you know, he takes me all the way up to the highest place, you know, and he offers me wine. He offers me cigars, you know, and then all of a sudden he says that if I want to drive the ship. And Ali goes on to say, like, this ship must be sinking, you know, and the crowd starts laughing, whatever. And then he knows what's going on, so he just says, like, you know, food for thought, you know, that's something to think about. But, you know, Gentiles being Gentiles and the world being as blind as it is didn't make much of it. Muhammad Ali had pointed out something that is now apparent, visible, and obviously upsetting a lot of so-called Americans, right? Pilgrim Americans, right? Well, anyways, so concerning Obama, I just want to make mention that we don't agree with what he's been doing. I'm sure he himself does not agree with what he's been doing, you know? It's not to say he's the best, he's the worst, but just to come to the truth and acknowledgement. Personally, I want to put this out there. All America, United States of the so-called Americas, all this that's going on, it's not Obama's fault, and you can't blame him, and you will, but it's dumb, and I want to do my part and put this out, because you know, we might have our differences. Regardless, compassion is there. He's in a difficult situation. He might not know the path, and therefore he's been willing to compromise. He's been turning to the left, turning to the right, you know, and not sticking to a path. Well, then maybe the problem is I have not taught him that path of Christ, the essence, and to stick to the straight and narrow way, you know, not consider, not make you know, not deal with anything else rather than that which is in Christ Jesus, right? But anyways, it's not his fault, you know, and that's that, and everyone's gonna blame him, and regardless of what he's done or what he hasn't done, it's not fair that they play the blame game. It's not his fault. Muhammad Ali in the 1970s, what, it's been almost 40 years now, clearly mentioned that the ship was sinking, you know, like, I've been a slave. Well, first of all, I've been stolen from my homeland. I've been put in a ship as if I'm material. I've been taken to a foreign land. I've been mistreated. Our women and children have been raped. Our children have been murdered. Our men have been humiliated. We've been enslaved. We've been struck. We've been smitten. We've been done all sorts of evil things, and all of a sudden it's like they want to hand over the baton, you know. It's like, hey, you want to drive this, you know, the ship must be sinking. So this is no new thing. If Muhammad Ali knew it back then white America and racist America, and not to say all white people, but, you know, majority Tea Party people that want their America back, right? Yeah, that in itself is delusional. But anyways, nonetheless, all those people that true, and even colored people themselves, and even, you know, immigrants and Hispanics and all of that, because there's some that do not have in their heart, you know, a a heart of love, where they cannot, where they can just see a person for what he is. No, they somehow get distracted by the outside appearance. Well, anyways, it's for all of them to know that this is not Obama's fault, and I personally am not gonna allow it to just be like that, where everyone wants to blame him. You know, given we don't agree, he has made some mistakes. Nonetheless, as far as the downfall of Babylon, I mean, United So-Called States of America, you can't pin it on him, you know? Our evidence has been put out earlier this year. Take a look at it. The video's called Ali Speaks on Being President. Now, one thing that President Obama did mention, and I put a video out earlier this year as well, around the same time, is there's a video clip where President Obama mentions the Sermon on the Mount, and he says, "The Sermon on the Mount, a speech, a lecture, a teaching so radical," and radical is defined as rooted, as so roots. So the video is called Sermon on the Mount is So Roots. So rooted and founded in truth. Mr. Obama does not say that, but he goes on to say, so radical that it's doubtful that even our defense system, even the defense system of the United States of America, even the military industrial complex, even that newly risen dragon cannot go up against it. And that, let I and I Rastafari remind the world, that is true. That is so roots, you know, it's so roots that President Obama said that in a time when he was less stressed out. If he lost focus and went the other way, or that other way, you know, I personally am not to judge, you know. Honestly, I even mentioned this to a co-worker at the time of when I was employed, and he said, you know, there's nothing he could do. And so let's give him that. I mean, he's in a difficult situation. Doesn't make right that which he's done and is wrong, and doesn't make wrong that which he's done that in fact is right. But nonetheless, America, racist America, you cannot pin this on Obama, because I pray that just as I, many others will speak out on this, you know? So it's simply not fair, not true, and not logical. So, you know, and if necessary, we'll put out more messages. But, you know, as far as the end of Babylon system, it's been coming for a while now. So give thanks to all for tuning in. Shalom, Rastafari.